GATE 2021 mock question number 6. The relatively capital abundant country X opens trade with the relatively labor abundant country Y, and trade takes place in accordance with the Heckscher-Ohlin model. Then what would be the relative factor price in the two countries? I am talking about the relative factor price as W by R. Okay, what will happen to W by R in the home country, and what will happen to W by R in the foreign country? Okay, what will happen? Tell me. So please understand that the X country, country X is this one, supposing, and the foreign country is country Y. Okay, now country X is capital abundant. So as trade opens up, country X will export the capital intensive good, and hence we will have an increase in the rental rate. Rental rate will increase for country X, and wage rate will increase for country Y. So what will happen is W by R for country X will fall, and W by R for country Y will increase. So fall in X and rise in Y. Because if I export the capital intensive good, obviously the capital intensive commodity will gain, the factor will gain, therefore the rent will increase for country X. The rental rate will increase for country X, and W will increase for country Y. Okay, answer is C. GATE 2021 mock question number 7. Which of the following could not be offered to theoretically explain the Leontief paradox? A relatively strong US demand for relatively labor intensive good. Obviously, if US had a strong demand for labor intensive, it would have imported labor intensive good. But in fact, we saw that US was exporting labor intensive good and importing capital intensive. That was the paradox in the first place. So this option B is mentioning the opposite. Okay, this is the answer. GATE 2021 question number 17 in the economics section. It's a direct question of the Harrod-Domar model. Harrod-Domar has a fixed technological relationship between capital stock and income. The model assumes flexible, so R is not there, TA is there. Answer is TA is true, but R is false. That's it. Okay, you'll get direct questions from the Harrod-Domar, from the Solow model, from basically the growth models. You'll get direct questions. Okay. IIT GATE 2021 mock economics section question 18. Suppose we run a bivariate regression of y on x and obtain the residual e. If we now regress e on x, the slope estimate should be, as I said, covariance xe should be equal to 0. Right? If covariance xe is equal to 0, the slope estimate will be 0. The residuals with x will not have any covariance, will not have any correlation. Therefore, the slope estimate should be 0. IIT GATE mock economics section question number 24. A friend has told that his multiple regression has a high R square, but all the estimates of the regression slopes are insignificant. Okay. Based on the t-test, this has probably happened because a high r-square, insignificant t-test. Why? Because explanatory variables are highly collinear. There is a multicollinearity problem. They are highly collinear, basically means that they have a very high correlation against each other.
orthogonal basically means independent. This is completely the opposite. Orthogonal basically that the explanatory variables are highly independent. If they are independent, that is good. But this is obviously a problem. This problem comes because of the high collinearity between the explanatory variables. IIT GATE 2021 mock test, question number 28. So what are we doing here? We are supposed to test mu is equal to mu naught versus the alternative mu not equal to mu naught. So it's a two-tailed test. Sigma square is unknown, so we'll use the t-test. Okay, we'll use the t-test. The critical region will be this part and this part, right? So basically z is greater than, sorry, not z, t, the t value or the statistic value, which is x bar minus mu naught by s by root n, sample standard deviation by root n, the value that I get, okay, should be greater than, this I call as t alpha by 2, this will be minus t alpha by 2. So this value should be greater than t alpha by 2. T mod value, x bar minus mu naught by s by root n, if it is greater than t alpha by 2, it will either lie in this region on the left or it will lie in this region. So this is when we will be rejecting it. That is x bar minus mu naught mod greater than s by root n into t alpha by 2. Bombay.
This is GATE 2021 economics section, question number 39. It's a direct question of finding out what will be the value of the human development index. Okay, as I shared with you earlier, the human development index is the geometric mean of health index or the life index multiplied by the education index multiplied by the income index. So a geometric mean of life index, education index and income index. So what am I going to do here? 0.805 multiplied by 0.513 multiplied by 0.559 whole to the power 1/3, and what will this come out to be? This will come approximately 0.6134, something like this you'll get. That will be your answer. So you enter the answer as 0.613 and you'll get that as correct. Okay, so this is about finding out the human development index.